wharf, a popular spot by the Potomac River, used to be filled with locals and tourists before the pandemic hit the US. Today, as the nation's capital starts to slowly ease out of the lockdown, people are back, though there are no crowds and everyone seems cautious.
People might still get sick and we might have a second wave, and I also really want to make sure that people are, you know, getting the economic opportunities that they deserve and that people are getting taken care of. So it's a mixed bag, I imagine.
DC Mayor Muriel Bowser said on June 17th that after 13 days of sustained decline of community spread, she expects the city to move to phase two of reopening in just a few days, which will allow gatherings of 50 people and many non-essential retail stores, restaurants, and places of worship, among others, to reopen at 50% capacity.
That we are trending in the right direction in each of these. Community spread at 13 days, low transmission rate, we have achieved positivity rate, we have achieved. For sufficient health care capacity, we have achieved, and we are trending in the right direction for contact tracing.
Michael Obindu is from Nigeria. He just graduated from Howard University with a master's degree in finance. He says he feels grateful, especially after 3 months of strict lockdown, when businesses were shut down and unemployment skyrocketed.
But the fact that we're getting there is really, really, helpful for people like me, recent graduate, looking for jobs and stuff like that.
Khalid Bengalem drove to D.C. from Florida with his family and says it is unusual to see the city so quiet, especially in the summer.
And I'm used to D.C. being busy with people. When we came in, it was like not a lot of people, and everybody was, we felt kind of safe, actually. Especially with things going on in Florida with the spike, and here everybody, you know, they had their mask and they taking the distances, which was great.
Bengalem's daughter Hannah has just finished her freshman year, and like most students, had switched to online learning in the last few months.
And it kind of gets lonely when we're at home, but the teachers still get to post stuff, and we do learn. But it's not the same face-to-face.
And while people seem to be venturing out more and enjoying the warm weather, most still prefer to take it easy, unsure of what the pandemic still has in store. Keita Kostreci, VOA News, Washington.